All right, what's going on, guys? It's Epoxy, and today we need to talk about the multiplayer for Cyberpunk, as there is a common misconception that Cyberpunk 2077 is getting a multiplayer component post-launch. And while that is sort of true, it's not quite what a lot of people think it is. So we're going to discuss this in detail for today's video to try and clear up all the confusion in relation to Cyberpunk multiplayer and some other details, such as when to expect it. So without further ado, let's roll the intro. So lately, I have noticed a large influx in comments from people that think Cyberpunk 2077 is getting the addition of a multiplayer mode added to the game, much like that of, you know, GTA Online. I even had people argue with me over this topic due to the amount of confusion of Cyberpunk's planned multiplayer. One of the most common places I see people arguing with my statement of no multiplayer mode is on my top 5 things people hate about Cyberpunk 2077 video, where I bring up the lack of multiplayer. I also put up a poll on the channel asking whether people think multiplayer is a part of Cyberpunk 2077 or a standalone release, with it averaging about 40% of people at the time of making this video thinking that it's a part of Cyberpunk 2077 and not a standalone release. That's quite significant. To be fair, I don't blame people for being confused about this, as CD Projekt Red hasn't exactly been very open and clear about the multiplayer for Cyberpunk. There's also been articles such as from The Verge misinforming people, implying that Cyberpunk 2077 is getting a, in quotes, multiplayer mode and, in quotes, multiplayer components. So people getting confused that it will be just getting a multiplayer mode that is added to the game is a fair expectation, especially with games like GTA 5 that released initially with no multiplayer but received GTA Online as an addition to the game post-launch. However, CD Projekt Red has never stated that they're bringing multiplayer to Cyberpunk 2077, only that they're working on what is codenamed Cyberpunk Multiplayer. Cyberpunk 2077 is a single-player open-world RPG. That is what the target audience is and was always meant to be. It is getting free updates as well as large single-player expansions post-launch. So let's explain what Cyberpunk multiplayer actually is, seeing as a lot of people don't truly seem to know. Just keep in mind, all of this is subject to change, knowing CD Projekt Red. In fact, it may have already changed. With that said, let's jump back to January of this year, where Adam Kaczynski, CD Projekt joint CEO, answered a few questions on an investor's Q&A. This was during the same investor's call about the April to September release date delay. Now, we're only interested in what he had to say about the Cyberpunk multiplayer, so here's what he had to say on that topic. In terms of multiplayer, one thing we need to make clear is that the AAA release we're working on in parallel with Cyberpunk 2077 is Cyberpunk multiplayer. So he made it very clear there that Cyberpunk multiplayer is a separate AAA release that is being worked on in parallel to Cyberpunk 2077. It's not just a multiplayer component. It's a separate AAA release. So Cyberpunk multiplayer is its own full-blown AAA project, separate from Cyberpunk 2077. Now, depending on your perspective, that can be either good or bad news. To me, that's good news, by the way. Now, the reason I think this is good news is because, one, it means that Cyberpunk 2077 is treated as its own AAA release, not just the single-player component of a game. So it is getting all the tender love and care of a full AAA project. CD Projekt Red is putting all of their effort into this game. Two, this means that Cyberpunk multiplayer is large enough to be considered its own AAA release by CD Projekt Red. So I would say expect a massive Cyberpunk spin on GTA Online. It will also mean that the game is more likely to receive better post-launch support, as it is a separate release that is coming out around 2 years after Cyberpunk 2077. Which, for those of you that also don't know, Cyberpunk multiplayer will likely not release until 2022 or even later. We know this as back in the same investor's Q&A, Kaczynski also stated the following. Given the expected release of Cyberpunk 2077 in September and the series of events which we expect to occur after that date, 2021 appears unlikely as the release date for Cyberpunk multiplayer. The release date of Cyberpunk multiplayer will probably move beyond 2021. keep in mind, that was a statement before Cyberpunk 2077 got delayed for a second time, now set for November. In fact, due to the second delay, we actually got an update for Cyberpunk Multiplayer's release window back in June during a CD Projekt Red conference call, where VP of Business Development, Michal Nowakowski, mentioned that the latest delay will also push back expansions and Cyberpunk Multiplayer, meaning that Cyberpunk Multiplayer, which wasn't even expected to release in 2021, will now be pushed back even further. So I would expect either mid or late 2022, if not later. Now, the question is, why a standalone release in the first place? First off, I'd expect that CD Projekt Red has big plans for Cyberpunk Multiplayer, knowing that it is standalone. This isn't going to be some silly deathmatch mode or some lackluster multiplayer. I'd honestly expect a free roam multiplayer that has story elements much like that of GTA Online, as well as tons of activities and content to take part in. Well, I myself am most interested in single player open world RPGs, so the single player is what I'm most interested in. A multiplayer Cyberpunk has a load of potential and could definitely be a solid multiplayer game that I would actively play. There's also the fact that it isn't expected to release until around 2 years after Cyberpunk 2077, which gives people plenty of time to play the heck out of the single player experience and likely dying for more Cyberpunk action by the time it rolls around. There's also the fact that CD Projekt Red isn't a huge fan of things like microtransactions, as they have confirmed there will be zero in Cyberpunk 2077 itself. So releasing this as a standalone AAA release would likely give them the profits to keep supporting the game post-launch without having to flood the game with microtransactions, especially like the pay-to-win stuff you see in GTA Online. Expecting a massive single-player open-world RPG game with no microtransactions is one thing. Expecting them to then throw in a multiplayer with that at no extra cost and not having to monetize the heck out of it to make it reasonably profitable is another thing. So it could just be CD Projekt Red's way of monetizing the multiplayer without having to flood it with microtransactions. It might also just be that big of a multiplayer. So Cyberpunk multiplayer might even blow away people that are fans of single player games. We're just gonna have to wait and see exactly what it offers. So again, it really just boils down to what makes sense for their development process. That being Cyberpunk 2077 first, that is the most important, and then Cyberpunk multiplayer after, which is less important. I think the separation of single player and multiplayer is a smart idea in this situation myself, but I'd love to know your thoughts on all of this down in the comment section below. But that's it for this video. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, please smack that like button down below, subscribe to Join the Good Fight if you haven't already, and ring that bell icon to stay updated in all of my future videos. It'd be super greatly appreciated as always. And until next time, this is Epoxy signing off.